Welcome back to the Budget Gamer channel, where we bring you critical and in-depth reviews of just about every indie game we can get our hands on, and today we're going to be doing a very special review. If you weren't aware, I got the flu last weekend, which is why there wasn't an upload on Monday, but in my fever-addled brain, I came up with the amazing idea to review two games side by side, with their only connection being one tiny gaming mechanic. And that is visual impairment. Video games being called video games obviously implies that you're supposed to be able to see something, so playing with a character with a disability is difficult in general. But the challenge of creating an enjoyable experience for a gamer with a main character who is visually impaired, now that's just something unique. So prepare yourselves and get ready for the side-by-side review of both Perception and Another Sight. Starting off by looking at Another Sight, it's pretty easy to see that this game was kind of loosely or very, very tightly modeled after Alice in Wonderland, with our main character starting off their adventure having fallen down some abandoned shaft into some underground area of Victorian England. It's not really explained how she loses her sight per se, but this is a new phenomenon in her life, and really puts a damper on her ideals of just kind of walking out back to the surface. Quickly though, she realizes that now for some reason she can more or less see sounds. And within the first few moments of gameplay, you meet your own version of the Cheshire Cat, who's a little more intelligent than you might expect, and who will act as both your literal and figurative guiding light to the end of the game. Perception, on the other hand, though obviously dealing with a similarly visually impaired main character, tells us that she was fully blind from a very early age and had to learn to manipulate sounds or basically start to perceive her world through echolocation. And after having been plagued by nightmares, almost driven to the brink of insanity, she's chosen to embark on a journey to go and confront this demonic manor that's plagued her dreams. But while in the game Another Sight, the main character Kit can call out to Hob, causing him to meow and light up the area, in Perception we can use a flurry of cane taps to light up a perimeter around ourselves and unveil the surrounding area for a few seconds at a time. Both games allow the player to see anything that actually makes noise, but again, both games require the player to pretty much light their own path to progression. Moving back into Another Sight, the game is largely divided into six main overarching chapters. Each chapter is focused around a character or icon from the Victorian era that you'll meet and interact with. And whether that's Edison, Tesla, or even the great painter Monet, every single area will be themed according to that interaction. Some might be massive gardens reflected in something akin to Alice in Wonderland, and others might be somewhat more steampunkish Victorian catacombs. But no matter which kind of area you're in, you'll have to be able to platform and puzzle your way through to reach the end of the game. As you might expect though, it might be difficult to play a full platforming game with a main character who can't actually see. So while our main protagonist Kit can walk around open doors and flip large toggles, her companion Hodge will be responsible for scaling up pipelines or climbing through small gaps and hitting pressure plates, and occasionally scaring away groups of mice or smaller critters so that both can move forward as a pair. Moving back to Perception though, the game is also divided into four main overarching chapters. But while the entirety of the gameplay is carried out within the confines of one single manor home, you'll play through different eras throughout the last century as they were redesigned and remodeled by the owners of that time. And so in that way, the developers made it to where every single chapter of this spooky horror survival seems like playing through an entirely new environment. Kind of like the profile information that you can find in Another Sight that help you build the larger backstory of what's going on, as you stumble your way through the dark through each of the game's chapters, you'll have access to several different keystones, whether they be a baby bottle or a shovel or a piece of paper, that each have lingering emotions and memories that give our character, through their version of Perception, the ability to share a memory of the denizen of that house from that time. And while you will certainly develop an appreciation for the overarching story as you play through the game, you can also creep through the main character's cell phone and listen to their last voicemails and text messages if you really want to get an idea of who you're playing the game as. Moving back to Another Sight though, as a 2.5D puzzle platformer, its visuals are most likely going to be its largest appeal for anyone playing the game. Navigating through surrealistic environments and using sight as sound and sound as sight in an almost synesthetic kind of way really does lend itself to creating some absolutely beautiful and vivid rich environments. But as a puzzle platformer, unfortunately, one of its weak spots actually is its puzzle platforming. The puzzling is actually fairly strong, and its need to coordinate between two different types of characters to solve the puzzles keeps it all feeling pretty fresh. However, it's the platforming part that really could use a little bit more polish. Hodge is, as mentioned before, your main champion of the platforms. He can crawl on pipes and reach through small holes and cross rather large gaps. But the issue with his analog controls really probably will agitate most players. The animations for his upward and forward jumping are completely separate, meaning you can't move to the right or the left if you're jumping upward, and for the type of game that it is, it requires an undue level of accuracy to make sure he can even grab a platform. Other than that, moving Hodge between a run and a walk is so finicky it almost seems random. And yes, this can severely impact the distance of your jumps if you're running up to an edge and then immediately start to walk right before taking that leap. The largest draw of Perception as well is likely its visuals. It's a unique game with a unique style, and other than the lather, rinse, repeat formula for a horror survival title, its unique reliance on sound for sight creates a fairly spooktastic vision of gameplay. And though early in gameplay you can beat the house to splinters tapping everything you can find with your cane, the more that you tap your cane around the house, the more the entity known as the presence becomes aware of your presence. And this, in a sense, sets the survival mechanic. The more you give yourself an advantage to see, the more you disadvantage yourself by allowing your presence to be known. And while this is a fairly brilliant dynamic, the main drawback of the game Perception is its repetition. As mentioned before, the entire game is carried out in the confines of one single manor home. It's reorganized across the four chapters to keep the player from actually memorizing where anything is, but despite the updated furniture and new touchstones that you can find throughout the house in each chapter, the gameplay does eventually digress into stumbling around in a darkened maze trying to find the cheese. But to sum it all up, and honestly something that I didn't expect when I started to record this review, is the binding point between both of these games. Yes, of course they're both based on characters who have visual impairment. Yes, of course they both used echolocation for sound and sight. But despite being two completely gaming genres, it actually seems like they might be most beneficial to the exact same gaming audience. As a 2.5D puzzle platformer, Another Sight might actually leave a true platforming fan with a bit of an average experience due to the mechanical issues with platforming itself. Similarly, as a horror survival title, Perception might leave a true horror fan with a fairly average experience due to some of the repetition. But if you are a story game fan, and here's where it gets interesting, if you're playing either one of these games for the story to unravel the mystery and figure out what's going on, you may indeed have a great experience with either one of these games. Both do offer several hours of gameplay with massive mysteries to unlock that can really only be solved through collecting information and building the story. And like I always say, it's not really about whether a game is good or is bad, it's more about what you expect from the game and what you want from it going in. So if you're diving into either one of these for the story or for the mystery, you might have a great time. But anyway, that does about wrap up the joint review of both Perception and Another Sight, both for the Nintendo Switch. So if you enjoyed this parallel review episode, or especially if you found it helpful, feel free to throw me a like or comment, share your support, and don't forget to click that little bell icon when you subscribe to stay updated with the latest content. As I'm hearing it from some of my fans, apparently YouTube did have a change, and you will not get notified about new reviews if you don't click that bell. And as there are literally thousands of indie games out there on the eShop for the Switch alone, and new and unique ones coming out every single day, there's always going to be some new cool indie to find out about right here. But anyway, this has been the Budget Gamer, so as always, thanks for watching.